already had this sort of printmaking kind of mindset, and then just in terms of, you know, the culture that I've found interesting.
It's basically, I would also say the body of work is kind of split probably 50-50 between sort of landscapes and portraits. But the two tend to sort of overlap. The landscapes actually become portraits, and the portraits become landscapes.
I started seeing things in the street, like the street signs that were vandalized. I saw kind of imagery in the street signs, and you know, the scratches and kind of stuff that would start shaping kind of figures and that, you know, almost representational kind of things. I just thought, let's see how this works in a painting. I thought, well, I'll start playing with making similar collages using street signs, kind of graphics and bits and pieces, magazines and things I found lying around. And of course, there were also like lots of similar things happening in terms of posters and music and stuff happening. And so I had a couple of these images lying around, these sort of collages that I had constructed. And for some reason, I don't know, but at some point I just decided, well, I'm going to try and reproduce one of these in a painting style. You'd have text, and you'll have like a political party statement, and you'll have like a bit of image left over, like eyes, little hand over here, or something, you know. So, yeah, and then concrete and rusted nails and or screws or whatever was part of it. Part of the thing that I find interesting, it is painting and digital culture, because is this digital culture, but it's a painting. I've also been developing kind of characters, I'd say, because also it sets up a narrative. The only, I suppose, commentary would be just the sort of mediated, sort of globalized kind of data, kind of internet culture, which I reckon no part of the world is immune to that. You know, and it's interesting in terms of an, if you'd say African context or South African context.